Usually they're not late. Yes, please. Go ahead. Oh, we missed one. You know, somebody can stand on the other side with Sarah.
Everybody's looking at the guy in the green cap.
Just everybody's looking at me.
Our final piece this afternoon is a song that many of you may recognize but not know that it is originally from Japan. How do I know this? My grandfather wrote the lyrics to it. Please join us in clapping your hands, stomping your feet, and tapping your shoulders.
Thank you. stone lantern you can see over there, that is 371 years old this year. The lantern symbolizes friendship and peace between Japan and the USA. This stone lantern was made in 1651 to mark the death of Tokugawa Iemitsu, the third shogun, the general of Tokugawa Dynasty. In 1954, lantern was moved from Japan to Washington, D.C. as a gift in commemoration of the 100th anniversary of America's first treaty with Japan in 1854. So, can you imagine that the 371 years old stone statue here in America? Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Scott Morris, and I am your co-host for this afternoon's festivities. And on behalf of my good friend and co-host, Akiko Keen, whom you just met, our colleagues at the National Conference of State Societies, the National...
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets regular, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star spangled
please join me in showing our appreciation to Miss Shimada Katani, Miss Weatherby, and the George Washington University U.S. Navy ROTC Color Guard.
Please keep standing. We will ask invocation from Reverend Saigo from Japanese Christian Church in Washington. Thank you.
桜の花を見ることができたことは、ただにこの肉体の目がその美しさを楽しんだだけでなく、心の中にほっとする安堵と、そして新しい希望を覚える経験でした。私たち日本人にとっては、今年の春はあの驚愕の大地震から満5年を記念する特別な時でした。神様、どうか今もなお復興という想像を絶する熾烈な戦いの中にある被災地の方々を覚えてください。私たちにとって忘れられるという経験ほど辛いことはありません。桜の花が毎年毎年春に変わらないで忘れずに私たちを訪ねてきて、慰め、励まし、希望を与えてくれるように、私たちも遠く離れたこの地から、これからも変わらずに誠実で心のこもった熱い声援と祈り、そして具体的な援助を被災地の方々に送り続けることができるように、力を与えてください。神様、あなたはこの大震災という不幸な出来事の中で、桜の木を通して、たくさんのことを私たちの人生について教えてくださいました。震災の中で作られたあの花は咲くという歌もその一つでした。折り返しの花は花は花は咲く、いつか生まれる君に、花は花は花は咲く、私は何を残したのだろう。その言葉は私たちの人生が、たとえそれが殉教の日であれ逆境の日であれ、単に今の自分のためにだけあるのではなく、いつか生まれてくる君のために、時代の人々のために、誰かに何かを残すためにあるのだということをしみじみと深く教えてくれました。神様、どうかいずこも混沌とした情勢の中にある世界諸国の為政者たちから始まって、国民の一人一人に至るまで、全ての人がこの桜の花を見ながら、この歌のように目の前より遠くを、自分と自分の国よりも遠くを見れるように助けてください。願わくはこの DC の桜祭りがもう一度私たちに、私たちの人生と今が何のためにあるのかを思い起こす時となりますように。特に今日この灯籠点火式が私たちの心にそのような火を灯す時となりますように。これらの祈りを私たちの作り主、また救い主イエス・キリストの御名によってお捧げします。Our Heavenly Father, once again, spring has come for us to enjoy the beauty of cherry blossoms. Especially this year, the winter was so tough for us, so we have been looking forward so eagerly to having warm weather. But still, we are cold today, though. This year is a sort of special year for us Japanese. We have just commemorated the 50th year anniversary of the Japan earthquake.On March 11, 2011. Blooming cherry blossom trees every spring for the last 5 years have been giving unspeakable impacts of encouragement, comfort, and even hope to so many people who have suffered by this earthquake in Japan. One of the songs composed to encourage them is Flower Will Bloom. The refrain of the song goes like this: Flowers will budAnd bloom again. For you who will come into the world someday, flowers will bud and bloom again. What have I done and left for you? What this song teaches us through these words is that our current and present life, whether that is fortunate or unfortunate, is not just for ourselves, myself, nor just for the current situations, rather for the future.For those who will be born in the next generation. Help us, O Lord, not to think and live just for ourselves only, nor just for the current situation only, but rather for other people. for the people who come into this world after us later. O Lord, you taught us this life lesson when all the things in front of us have so easily collapsed in a few moments. Lord, you taught us this same or at least similar lesson as we went through the tragedy on September 11, 2001 in the United States too.
Also, that we have 2016 Japan Princess, and Miyuko Niwa moved from Japan with her parents living in Maryland, and she is a member of Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society and the Dean's List. And Miyuko is the daughter of Akihiro and Keiko Niwa, who is member of JCAW. And also, Miyuko is an excellent student. She's looking forward to going to the university to graduate in 2 years. Congratulations for these beautiful ladies.
Hello, my name is Amy Anda, and I'm the director of the Cherry Blossom Princess Program and Alumni Network. And I'm pleased today to introduce Noelle Verhelst, who is the 2015 United States Cherry Blossom Queen. Originally hailing from the great state of Nevada, she is currently a legislative assistant on Capitol Hill, and she will now join us to offer a message this evening.
Konnichiwa, watashi wa Noelle desu. Watashi wa Las Vegas kara kimiwashita. Dozo yoroshiku onegaishimasu. Good afternoon. My name is Noelle Verhelst, and I'm the United States Cherry Blossom Queen. Over the past year, I've had the opportunity to serve my country to further strengthen the bond between the U.S. and Japan. I'm very proud to have played a role in this symbolic.
My name is Kiva Lapidi, who's representing America's
Idol. The District of Columbia, where we sit today, Alexandra Chittum. From the state of Florida, Rachel Soloway. Georgia, Zelly Duvall. Heading to Guam, we have Diana Cruz. Then out to Hawaii, we have Emily Hopi. Going to Idaho in our west, we have Estefania Gongora. To my home state, Illinois, Annie McDonald. Next, we have Allison Tucker from Indiana. Now to one of our international partners in 2016, representing Italy, Elisabetta Iannetti. Then, of course, representing Japan, Miyuko Niwa. Then we have Victoria Lee representing Kansas. Brittany Brumback representing Kentucky. Hannah Savray representing Maine. Amanda Bucher representing Maryland. Alexandria Murphy representing Massachusetts. Another one of our international partners this year, Mexico, Roberta Elizondo Ibarra. Representing Michigan, Zoe Jenkins. Then we head to Minnesota, Coral Krentz. Sarah Weatherby, representing Minnesota, and your national anthem singer. Then we have Megan McCain representing Missouri.
Liana. Liana.
Oh my God. Congratulations.
I know, but I'm
sure.
Oh, I'm sure.
Yeah.